Hello, everyone. My name is Tatiana. I'm from JetBrains, and I'm going to talk about RubyMotion support in RubyMine. And first of all, a couple of words about myself to start with. So you can see some Insta image. It aims to tell you something about me. Okay, I'm not a hipster, even if it looks like. Okay, so actually I used to be a Ruby on Rails developer. It was a long, long time ago, about 10 years ago, even more. So, you know, these times when it wasn't a trend yet. Then I had been working as a project manager and as a agile coach, but now I am a product marketing manager, JetBrains, in the RubyMine team. So, RubyMine, I hope you've heard about it, or even have tried it, or use it on your daily basis. So, RubyMine is the most advanced Ruby and Rails IDE. I believe in it, it is the best one. Okay, so, but the story is not about Ruby and Rails today, the story is about RubyMotion. So, in February 2012, RubyMine actually became a RubyMotion IDE. That time, we were very excited about RubyMotion. And from one hand, we had our RubyMine with all the intelligence for Ruby coding, because we have our code completion, smart navigation, and a lot of refactorings features. We have our visual debugger, test runner. We have our integration with version control system, and so on and so forth. And on the other hand, we have app code. We had app code, and we actually do have it at the moment. It is our Objective-C IDE, and nowadays it is Objective-C and Swift IDE. And this IDE has all the intelligence for Objective-C. So we have decided that we could do our best to take from both worlds the benefits of both our IDEs and to make an integration of RubyMotion. So since February 2012, RubyMine became a RubyMotion IDE, and actually since then JetBrains has been supporting all the RubyMotion inspect events. So I hope it's not only collaboration but a kind of friendship. So no more words. I'm going to have a small demo. Just a short note, please be patient, because I'm not a developer, as I said. I'm a product manager, so please be patient. Okay, let's switch to RubyMine. So I want to start with the very beginning. I want to create a new project in RubyMine. So RubyMotion application, definitely. Let it be, sorry, hello motion, yeah. And I can choose here what application should it be. I mean, iOS or 6 or even Android. But I'm going to create a small app for my iPhone, so I will choose iOS. Let's do create it. Okay, you can see here that everything was created. You can see it here. And RubyMine suggests us to run Bundler, but I won't do that because I'm sure that all the games are already installed. So not this time. But you can if you want to. And I'm going to also switch to presentation mode. Here it is. No. So enter presentation mode. Just for you to see better. So you can see everything was created, like app delegate class, it was generated, and spec, so everything you need. And more than that, RubyMine also creates these predefined rig tasks to run your simulator and to run your test. So you actually can run your simulator. So let's do. Oh, sorry, I'm trying to debug. Not this time. I can do it, but not this time. So, once again, I'm going to close my debug. Yes, I need to use Shift. Run, simulate, yeah. Now it's true, so you can see our simulator. And here. And here it is, yeah. So it's a simple just generated RubyMotion app. But of course, I want to add some code. And I'm going to start with creating my own controller. I don't want to use UI view controller. I want to use my own controller. Let's do. So here it is. And you can see that RubyMine highlights it as an arrow, because we don't have such a class. And I want to create it. And I can do it with the intention action. So just with the help of RubyMine, I'll create a new class here on my arrow, choose the right folder, and here it is. You can see my hello controller. I'm going to inherit it from UI view controller. And here you can see our code completion is working, and even I can type just first letters like V and C for view controller, and RubyMine finds it for you. I definitely need some view did load. Yeah, here it is. And I want to create just a simple label. Let it be UI label. Yes. Mm-hmm. And I'm going to init it with frame. And UI screen again. Main screen and bounce. So label, and I want to add some text here like hello from JetBrains, and I need to add it as a subview. So looks good. Let's try to run it. Running again. Now simulator again. Okay, hello from JetBrains. Whoa. but I don't really like how this label looks like, so I want to play with it a little bit. And what I want to do is to go for the moment to exit my presentation mode, and I will open console here. Okay, so I'm going to console, and what I want to do is just to play with it. So like command click, and I'm in a label now. And I want to change, for example, a text color. Let's do. Oh, sorry. Self text. Whoa. Text color. Whoa. It's not really sitting down. Not really good. Okay, so I'm going to use UI color. Where it is? Yes, here it is. And you can see again code completion in console. It's so I can just choose, for example, the blue color. And here it is. Yeah, it's blue. Yeah. Exactly. And for example, I want to change font as well. So let's do it like UI font. Yes, here it is. And I'm going to font with name. Yeah. You can see that when RubyMine completes everything, it also adds some parameters that you can easily change. So here I'm going to change my font name. And I'm going to change like size. Let's see. Yeah, it's a little bit too big. So I'm going to change it once again. Okay, pretty good. so when I'm after I play with it a little bit, I at some moment want to add this code to my app. So I don't need this one anymore. But I want to go here and copy like this one, and go back to editor, and edit, and again, go back to my console, and this one, yes, this line I also needed, okay, and go back. Okay, so let's So into presentation mode again, just for you to see. So we have some code, but we have an errors, of course, because we have self not labeled here. So I'm going to change it. And I can use our multiple source options, because I have two places where I want to change it. And I start typing, and code completion helps me again. So here it is. I also want to center it. So it's, yes, it's text alignment. And I remember that there is some, like, text alignment center. Yeah, here it is. But what I don't like about this code is that definitely I want to extract a method here. I don't want to be this in my view did load. So I can do that. I need to just select this one and extract a method. It is a special refactoring of RubyMine. So like let it be make label and magic. Yeah, make label was created, as you can see, and here it is invoked. So, but another thing that I want to do is to make this local variable to be an instance one. So I'm going to rename it in all the places with one shift F6. So just to. So here it is. So now I have some label, yeah, and seems to work. But I want to add some interaction, of course. It's a little bit boring to have just a simple label to my app, so I'm going to add it. And I have prepared some live templates before the talk, just to be a little bit more fast. And or snippets, called snippets, if you use through this title. So I'm going to add interaction. So it was a snippet, called snippet, that adds some code fragment for me. And here it is. But what I can see here is that, again, RubyMine highlights me an error, because I don't have such a method, and I do have such an action. And actually, one more thing here is that every time you don't remember some useful information about your methods or classes, you want to invoke a quick documentation. So actually, if I'm not sure what action or what target means here, I can just take a look. Okay, but I still don't have a method. So I'm going to invoke intention action again in RubyMine and create a method. That's it. And here I can change some label text. Yeah. So let it be. Yeah, here it is. So I think that it's time to check that everything is still working. Let's rerun. Okay, so it's my app. It's hello from JetBrains. Yeah. So great. So go back to my code. But one more thing that I want to add here is just not to change the text of my label, but to choose some randomly this text from some JSON file. I want to add such a logic to my app. So I do have a special class prepared. Lucky random. I'm going to copy it and add it here. So just copy and paste. So it is a very simple class that reads JSON file and like first name and last name, and then there is a random answer. So it just shows a random name from this list, from this file. So nothing really complicated. But what I want to do is here. To do here is I need to go back to my controller. Yes, here it is, and I want to create some lucky one. like lucky random, new, and I'm going to change it is here like lucky and random answer. So here it is. So now I'm going to check if everything is still working again. But I think that the best way is not to run the simulator, but to run a test. To run a test, to create it first and then to run. So I'm going to main spec here and want to add some test like describe. Yeah, here it is. Let's check our controller. And we need to mention that it tests our controller again. Code completion helps me a lot, as I'm not a developer, you remember. So. And again, I have some live template here just to save my time. So just a code fragment here that checks that after the label was tapped, the text was changed. OK, so here it is. RubyMine, again, highlights some errors. Don't like double quotes here. I don't like it either. So I want to convert a single quote. And I can do it not only in this one exactly place, but I can do it all over the file. So fix it for all my tests. OK, so as you remember, we have our predefined rake task created by RubyMine. It was one for simulator and another one for test. So let's try to run it. And here it is. Yes, it is running. So it's something goes on. And we can see the results here. Okay. So oh yeah, sure. Thank you. Yes, I don't have a JSON file. So I want to go here and create some new file. JSON, well, not to let it be applicants. It should be applicants. JSON. So I have some code here, like to insert something. And you can see that there are a lot of errors here, because I don't have right syntax. And you can see that, again, it is an error here. And I can navigate just to an error place, missed comma here. And now I can reformat this code just to look at more readable. So OK, JSON file is here. So let's go back to our tests. Yeah. I'm going to run it once again, so run my tests. Okay, so it's running, but they're not green ones. Something goes wrong. So first of all, we don't have a one window. We actually do have two of them. And another one, we can't find a view with label. So let's try to fix it. I'm going to my tests, so I think that I need to do it a little bit and close this one. Yes. So I will change the test, and here I need to add a title to my label. So I'm going to controller, and I want to add like title here. And I'm going to set like an accessibility label and title. And I'm going to add here is like my label. So here it is. Let's try to rerun. Hooray, everything is green. You can see that all the tests were passed. So it seems that now we're pretty ready for deploying to a device. Yeah. But before doing that, I'm going to get back to my presentation, and here it is. It is a small surprise for you. Yes, because I'm going to shuffle 5 free licenses, and of course I want to do it with my sample app. But for doing that, I need to change my application JSON file with the list of all of you, of all attendees. And I have prepared such a list. Let's go back. Here it is. Okay, so I need to go back. Let's close this. And I need to go here and resources. Yes, and I want it to be applicants. And I want to override it. Yes, definitely. I have only emails, sorry for that. Not names, but I hope that you will recognize yourself. And I need to change a little bit a lucky random as well, because I do have last and first names here, and now I'm going to have an email here. Okay, so let's go back to our tests again and run them again, just to make sure everything is still working. So cross your fingers. Okay, everything seems to be okay. So now we are ready to deploy. I'm going just to be sure. I want to run simulator once again, just to look at my app. Okay, so I think it was started. Yeah, here it is. Okay, so a lot of emails. So that's it.
Must be present to win. Yeah. Too soon.
So we are ready to deploy, and I'm going to shuffle from my iPhone, so to be like a real demo to have it. So, but before deploying, I need to prepare a little bit. For example, I need to take my mobile provision file. Yeah, you know, all of. And I need to edit here. And I want to have a cute icon as well. Yes, let it be. And I also need to change my reg file. And again, I have just a live template to do that to save time. So bingo. Now we are ready to deploy. And I have my iPhone ready. So here we need to invoke a rake task, so I'm going to go to reload list of tasks. Yes. So again, you can see the list of all rake tasks here, and I need device. Yes, here it is. And cross your fingers again. Deploying. Yeah, here it is. Yeah, hello from JetBrains. You can see that. Yeah. Okay, great. But what I want to do is I want you to see the results. And it's very hard to see on my phone. So I'm going to run a debug session here. So, and to put a breakpoint so you can see the answers. And I need to prepare a little bit. I need to go to my controller again. And what I want to do is I want to put a breakpoint here. But before I do that, I need to extract a variable. I will do it with extract variable refactoring again. Let it be a random answer. So extract it. And now I can just put a breakpoint here. So you will see the value that this random answer gets. And now I'm going to debug this time. So something is going on. Deploying. Yes, I can see my app. Okay, so here it is. Now you can see I have my app here. Hello from JetBrains still. And I tap here. And so Alan is the first lucky one. So great. Congrats. So I need to just run it, and I will see it there, and I will copy it for myself. Yeah, and four more times here. So again, tapping. Again, you can see your random answer. So Matthew. Okay, great. Oh, by the way, you can see everything on yourself under your variables as well. So if you want to see, if you want to see the list of applicants or to check something, and you can actually add some expression or variable to the watches, but I won't do that at the time. So, okay, the second lucky one. Let's copy. And again, tapping. And so, Philip. Okay, so no Philip, but he's still a lucky one. So he gets his license. Okay, so Philip, it was the third one, yes, fourth one. So, okay, not here again, but still copying it to myself. Yes, and the last one, so, yeah, exactly. So, okay. Yeah. I can try another one. I think there. It will be fair. So, the last one this time. So, David. Okay, great. Congratulations. So just to okay, so I will send an email with instructions how to get license afterwards, because I saved all the emails. So, and actually here it is, with a small demo of just the most basic features of our support. So we can now just go back to my presentation. So, and I want to share some useful links with you as well. So first of all, you can read about all our features on our site, so the first link. And you can always download and try RubyMine, not only for RubyMotion development, if you want to, for Rails development and Ruby development as well. We have our 30-day trial, so feel free to try to play with it before making a decision to buy it or not to buy. Yeah. So one note here, short disclaimer, you know we have this, as Laurent said, conference-driven development. So yesterday I found a couple of bugs, frankly speaking, while preparing, and Dennis fixed them yesterday, and I want to show you Dennis, because I'm not a developer, he is a developer for sure. He's a guy who stands behind RubyMotion integration and RubyMine, so pink him. If something doesn't work, so please pick him, not me. Okay, so Dennis has fixed it yesterday, and it is not still uploaded to our site, so we are going to make our next minor release today or tomorrow, so please be patient. But you still can try it. It's not everything is broken, you know. Okay, so another good link is the student one. I hope that there are some students here. We have free licenses for students. You need to apply to get your free license. So please do it following this link if you want to. Yeah. And we also have 30% discount for startups. So if you're a startup, you need to apply as well. So you can do this. And you're more than welcome to email me directly or to our support if you have any questions about RubyMine, RubyMotion, whatever, or just want to chat. I don't know. So here it is. So thank you for your time. And so you can ask questions, and yes, just a moment. And more than that, we are going to be here tomorrow, evidently, and today, and we are wearing this RubyMine t-shirt. So if you want to ask something, please just stop by and ask. So questions. Yeah, sure. Yes, let's stop our debugging session this time and close. Yes, and close this one and yeah. So where should I go?
On the line, recognize it equals UI
test. Yeah.
And it says action colon change label, which is a string. Mm-hmm. Before you had the method change label, it was saying syntax error, but that's a string. How did it know? So is it where enough?
Okay, so
that method actually the string there is mm-hmm. method name, that method didn't exist. Is that
like I think
change change label?
Yeah. Yeah, we can change it and like here, yeah. And it will highlight it. Yes. Yes. So about the tricks, I think that Dennis maybe should answer these questions as a developer. Yeah. So, other questions? Yes.
So, the auto completion looks like it works really, really good with like just the Objective-C APIs. Mm-hmm. How does it integrate with gems or like other files that I've created in my project?
It works for gems as well. You need to, of course, to install them. And RubyMine, actually, if you have a rake file, if you have a bundler, and if you have your gem file, RubyMine looks on your gem file and checks everything and going through your gems. And even in the debugging session, not even the code completion, you can go into your library code, into your gems. Yeah, to your gems. It is now working for Android. There are some issues to be fixed there, yeah, frankly speaking, but basically, yes. I hope so. I believe in it. Debugger does not work yet. I think that we are waiting for some fixes from Laran. Laran, hi. Yeah. So as soon as we get some fixes, I hope Dennis will integrate that to RubyMine. Yes, we do. Yeah.
You're talking about it looking at the selector. If you have a target of a different object, will it actually go and inspect what it thinks that object is, or how is that?
So, you see that I used to be a Ruby developer, and me personally, I do like RubyMotion because for me, I can code, make some Ruby coding still, because I still prefer it. It's not my everyday work, but I still do like to code something for myself. And from this point of view, developing for iPhone is really good for me because I want to create something that I can use. And I'm using my apps. I'm creating. Sometimes I create some simple games for my son or some simple to-do list for myself, and that's it. So I'm very naive. I'm like a beginner. Yeah, but still, yes, I do like to code a little bit like a hobby. So thank you then.
Okay, everyone, I think we're ready for the lunch break. I've been told that the room next door is open and air conditioned. I don't know if there's food in there yet, but it's on its way. What's the...
I think you had us at air conditioned.
I suggest the food is there.
Okay. What time should you be back from lunch next door? I'll be there. I'll yell at you. Thanks again to Tatiana and JetBrains. They've been a strong supporter of RubyMotion since day one. So yeah. Thanks for backing us up.